मॉर्निंग क्लास सिक्स माई सेल्फ रंजीत कुमार योर साइंस टीचर आई वेलकम यू ऑल इन द ई लर्निंग प्रोग्राम ऑफ मॉडर्न इंग्लिश स्कूल कुंती नगर नवादा. सो टुडे इज द सेकेंड लेक्चर ऑफ द चैप्टर सेपरेशन ऑफ सबस्टांस. सो इन द फर्स्ट चैप्टर फर्स्ट लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस व्हाट इज मिक्सचर. व्हेन टू और मोर प्योर सबस्टांस इज मिक्स टूगेदर इट फॉर्म अ मिक्सचर. सो see here, take two container. I have taken two container. In both container I have taken water. In both I have taken water, pure water. What do you mean by pure water? Means water that contains, means a substance is pure, said to be pure if contain only one type of substance. Means if I have only water, nothing else, not even salt dissolved in it, purely only water, then it is called pure water. Okay, so this is the pure water. In this I have added salt. And in this I have added sand. So when I add salt here, I add sand here, then it become a mixture. So both become mixture because it was pure water, it was pure sand, I mixed together. So two pure substance mixed together form mixture. Here there was pure salt and there is pure water, I mixed together and it become mixture. So I made two pure substance and made a mixture. What is the difference between these two? What is the difference? If you take salt here and dissolve it, salt will dissolve evenly, means salt will get dissolved. So salt get dissolved, but sand do not. So sand do not get dissolved, so there must be some difference. So this is a homogeneous mixture and this is a heterogeneous mixture. Homogeneous mixture and heterogeneous mixture. Okay. What is the difference? If I tell you, take a pipette or you can say anything, dropper. You take a dropper and what you do, take a place the tip of the dropper here and take some sample from here. This is sample A and now place the tip of dropper here and take sample B. Now what is the difference? Since sand is not soluble, do not get dissolved, it will settle at the bottom. So this sample B contains more sand and this sample A contains less sand. So composition of sand is different within this. So homogeneous mixture, what is heterogeneous mixture? A mixture in which different part shows different composition and properties is called heterogeneous mixture. Right? Homogeneous mixture, mix structure that do not show different properties and composition is called homogeneous mixture. Means a mixture that do not show different properties and composition is called homogeneous mixture. What I mean to say that you take a drop of water from here and a drop of water from here, both will taste same, dono ka taste same hoga. So we can say if the impurity is soluble, then it forms a homogeneous mixture. And if the substance which we are adding is insoluble, it forms a heterogeneous mixture. So mixture are of two type, homogeneous mixture and heterogeneous mixture. Okay. The next topic which we have already discussed, but it has to be discussed, what is the need for separation, why we need to separate. So 3 points I have discussed, that we need to separate the substance because we remove the undesirable substance, we obtain to obtain desirable substance, and to obtain substance in the highly pure form. So these are the need for the separation of mixture. So it has to be discussed. I have discussed you in the last video also. Today also I am saying, keep in mind. So different methods for separation are: first, hand picking. It is a method of hand picking. It is a method in which the unwanted substance is picked manually with the help of hand and it is separated. Next is winnowing. What is winnowing? Winnowing, it is a method of separating lightweight impurity from the heavyweight pure substance or the desirable substance. For example, in the grains you have husk, bhusi. So what you do? You take the grains and the husk, soup hota hai na, soup mein leke, and you drop it from the height. When it falls, the husk will blow along with the air and it will go somewhere else, and the heavy particle will settle at the bottom. So this is called winnowing. Third method is sieving. Means chalna, kisi cheez ko chhanna. चाय छानते हैं, दैट इज सीविंग. वो कंकड़ वगैरह चालते हैं आटा में से, अनवांटेड सब्सटेंस, भूसी, खल्ली, जो भी है, जो भी अनवांटेड सब्सटेंस है उसको सेपरेट करते हैं, दैट इज कॉल्ड सीविंग. फोर्थ इज मैग्नेटिक सेपरेशन. What is magnetic separation? It is the method of separating magnetic substance from non-magnetic substance. For example, you have a iron piece that is magnetic, that attracted by the magnet, and it is there mixed with some non-magnetic substance. If you place the magnet, all the magnetic substance get struck into the magnet and non-magnetic substance remain there. So it is a method of separation of magnetic substance from non-magnetic substance. Next, fifth is sedimentation and decantation. Take a glass
of water, add sand in that, you mix it, you will see sand will float everywhere. Leave it as it is. After half an hour, all sand will settle down at the bottom. This process is called sedimentation. The process of allowing insoluble impurity to settle at the bottom is called sedimentation. And once the insoluble impurities settle at the bottom, slowly pour the clear liquid into another container. So this is decantation. Pouring the clear liquid is called decantation. So sedimentation and decantation. Next, fifth is filtration. What is filtration? Filtration means it is the process filtration. It is the process in which we separate the insoluble impurity with the help of filter paper. That is called filtration. Seventh, filtration, and next is churning. What is churning? मक्खन निकालते हैं दूध को महने मथने के बाद या दही को. सो आफ्टर डूइंग दैट दिस प्रोसेस इज कॉल्ड चर्निंग. मीन्स बटर इज सेपरेटेड फ्रॉम कर्ड और द मिल्क इज कॉल्ड चर्निंग. नेक्स्ट इज इवेपोरेशन. What is evaporation? It is a process of separating soluble impurity. For example, you mixed salt and water accidentally, or you mixed the salt and water. You want to separate the salt from that. What you will do? You simply heat the water. All the water will get evaporated and salt will be there in the container. So by this, by evaporation, we can obtain separate the soluble impurity. And the last one is distillation. Evaporation and distillation both are related. Distillation, it is up in evaporation. What is the difference between evaporation and distillation? In evaporation, we only obtain the solid impurity. And the water get evaporated, we lost the water. But in distillation, we obtain both. We obtain water also and salt also. So all these 9 different methods of separation we have to discuss one by one. I have just given you a small brief so that you can read in your book and try to understand. And in coming videos, we will discuss all these things one by one. Okay, in detail. Okay, if any problem, please ask. Okay, thank you for the day.